My name's Rick Copeland, and my wife, Carol, and I operate the Better Business Bureau of the Tri-Counties. Welcome to this week's edition of Your Moment of Trust. Thanks for tuning in to Your Moment of Trust. The Better Business Bureau fosters honest and responsive relationships between businesses and consumers, instilling consumer confidence and advancing trustworthy marketplace for all.
We'd like to thank Ayers Automotive Repair for supporting Your Moment of Trust with timely advice from BBB of the Tri-Counties. Ayers Automotive Repair is a proud member of the Better Business Bureau, providing dependable, trustworthy auto repair services in Santa Barbara since 1979.
Hi, this is Charlie with another Ayers Auto Tip of the Week. These days, many vehicles have an oil life monitor that tells you when it's time to change your oil. Otherwise, follow the instructions in your owner's manual. Ask your technician to print out the maintenance schedule for your make and model. Regular oil changes keep your engine running in top condition, saves gas, and helps you avoid major repairs.
Welcome to this week's edition of Your Moment of Trust. Healthcare scams are as varied as just about any con out there. The fraudster often poses as a government authority to persuade you to provide personal information related to your Medicare or Medicaid account for identity theft. In other cases, the con artist is after your health insurance, Medicaid, or Medicare information to submit fraudulent medical charges. Here's how the scam works. Typically, the scam starts with an email, text message, or phone call that appears to be from a government agency. Con artists use a variety of stories. In one common version, the agent tells you that he or she needs to update account information to send a new medical card. In another version, the scammer asks for your account number in exchange for free equipment or services. A third version involves a threatening robocall purporting to be from HealthCare.gov or the health insurance marketplace. You're told you must buy health insurance or face a fine. Sure enough, you're soon asked to provide personal information. A more recent version has reported Medicare recipients receiving notices that new Medicare cards with microchips will be sent out and further verification is required. Here are tips to avoid this scam. Don't trust a name or number just because it shows up on your caller ID. Con artists use official-sounding names or mask their area codes by spoofing to make you trust them. Don't fall for it. Hang up and go to official websites. You can enroll or re-enroll in Medicare at medicare.gov or a marketplace health plan at healthcare.gov. Never share personally identifiable information with someone who has contacted you unsolicited, whether over the phone, by email, or on social media. This includes banking and credit card information, your birth date, social security or social insurance number, and of course your health insurance number. Guard your government-issued numbers. Never offer your Medicare ID number, Social Security number, health plan information, or banking information to anyone you don't know. Medicare will never contact you via email, text message, or phone asking you to verify personal information. Today's tips are brought to you by BBB of the Tri-Counties.
Thanks for tuning in to Your Moment of Trust. The Better Business Bureau can help you resolve disputes and find trustworthy businesses. Feel free to stop by our Santa Barbara office at 211 East Victoria Street, Suite A, or our Camarillo office at 4001 Mission Oaks Boulevard, Suite G, or call us at 805-963-8657. Until next time.